Magic Johnson saying the Spurs choked. Do you still feel that way?
Yeah, I mean, you can say choke or gave it away. You know, I've been there, you know, and this is nothing but coming from my heart and from my experience, where we had Boston down in 84. We won the first game. We gave them or choked the second game. We gave it back to them on their home court, and that really turned the series back around, and they eventually, I blew game seven for our team. That was the longest summer. Now, the difference is, and we just talked about this, Skip, they have a chance still to win the championship.
Redeem.
Yes. Yep, yes. Can. You know, and so this is about the mental state of the Spurs. It's not about anything other than that. Can Kawhi get over the missed free throw? Can Ginobili say, I missed a free throw, but I had eight turnovers. Can I get over that and come back and say, I'm going to be okay? Now, to me, you made a great point of what Popovich did, Skip. That was wonderful. Taking them all out to dinner, bringing them together and say, hey, guys, we still got a chance. We got one more game. But to me, the bigger thing than Pop is, can Tony Parker and Tim Duncan rally the guys? Because you got some young guys who didn't play well in game six. You know, and so Kawhi, can he overcome that? So the experienced guys got to rally behind that young man and say, hey, it's going to be okay. Danny Green, uh-oh, you finally had a bad game. You got to step up in game seven because we can't, I don't think they can win without him not playing well. So he has to step up in game seven. So it's going to be, to me, the experienced players, the leaders have to rally around those young guys and get them ready for game
you
seven.
Seem to be more concerned with, you know, their mentality and their mental approach to game seven. Mm-hmm. I'm primarily focused on the physical simply because you are playing a game seven less than 48 hours after game six. Tim Duncan's 37, Manu Ginobili's 35, and when Tony Parker, for some reason, when he comes out of the game, you know, it seems as if Popovich believes that Manu Ginobili is the only person that he can rely upon. Mm-hmm. So I'm concerned about whether or not San Antonio has enough gas left in the tank to overcome tonight's game. To that, you say what?
I say there is a concern there, no question about it, because their age. But at the same time, you got to be concerned about Miami, too, then. Mm-hmm. Dwayne Wade, Battier, Ray Allen, they're all up in age. Mike Miller. To me, actually, the age gap goes to San Antonio more than it goes to the Heat. I mean, to me, that favors San Antonio because I think that they can overcome the age factor more than the Heat can.
But Tim Duncan played 45 minutes.
But remember where he gets his shots from. 5 feet away from the basket. He's going to be okay. And one thing about Tim, he sees his fifth championship in sight, right? The man is the smartest player on that court, okay? LeBron may be the best in the world. Yes, he is. But on that court tonight, the smartest player in the building will be Tim Duncan. So he'll know how to use his experience to overcome fatigue.
Last question about this before we go to Skip. You say the smartest player on the court. Magic, that resonates with me if it were you or somebody playing the guard spot, somebody with the ball in their hands that's running plays, as opposed to the big man down low that's looking to be fed. Isn't there something to be said? When you say Tim Duncan's the smartest player on the court, how significant is that considering the fact that he's not a backcourt player?
Well, see, when I say smartest player on the court, he's been there. He's done that. He understands what he has to do. You know why? Because he's been in four championship series already. He's already understand what having only a day rest means and coming back playing the next night. He understands that. So you don't worry about Tim Duncan. You got to worry about Tony Parker because he's the one got to spend a lot of energy to go pick and roll, to also get back on defense, be the first
player.
With
the strained hamstring.
Exactly. So you worry more about Tony, to me, than you worry about Tim. But the main guy who has to get off is Ginobili. If Ginobili can get off, now you're looking at a tough Spurs team to beat.
Skip believes in him. You believe in that?
I believe in him.
Yeah, well, you know what? Ginobili is one of them dudes who he doesn't care if he goes 0 for 20. Mm-hmm. The next game he could be hot. You know, that's who he is. He's a wild card. He's one of them guys don't care. Oh, if I shoot 15, miss 15, the 16th shot is going to go in.
I used the choke word on Ginobili the other night, and I love Manu and have loved him for a long time. But he can't miss that free throw. Mm-hmm. Kawhi Leonard is 21 years of age. This is his first time in the bright lights.
Right.
So, and I didn't think Kawhi choked his free throw. He got it up on the rim. Mm-hmm. It just missed.
Right.
And then he regathered himself and made the second one, which I thought was pretty important and pretty impressive. But Ginobili owes this team a game now. Mm-hmm. That was just flat out nightmarish. That was pathetic. He owed them game five after game four, and he brought it.
Yes, he did.
And that was so. Where did that come from? Mm-hmm. It's heart of a champion. Mm-hmm. This man has three rings. He has a gold medal that he won for Argentina. I think he will play game seven closer to game five than game six.
Well, Skip, what he has to do is quit giving away unforced turnovers.
Stephen A. said
that. He can't jump up in the air trying to make a
play. Nowhere to go.
Nowhere to go. He's done that. The other night when he had eight turnovers, five of those were jumping up in the air trying to make a play happen. Yes.
Right.
So tonight, come down. Don't jump in the air. Just gather yourself with the ball. Make the proper pass. And so if he does that, and he's a smart basketball player, so the Spurs have to cut down on their mistakes. Tonight it's going to be about turnovers, offensive rebounds, and defensive rebounds, because those are going to be, when you look at the stat sheet, you're going to say, okay,
all right,
too many turnovers.
Right. Get,
and now the Heat is the best in the business at getting a steal, making a turnover, and getting into the fast break.
We've talked so much about the San Antonio Spurs, but we've also talked a lot about the Miami Heat in terms of LeBron James. Tonight, Skip has talked about legacy game, those kind of things. What's your mentality about that, watching LeBron James, seeing what you've seen, being critical of him when you deem necessary, being incredibly gracious towards him when he deserved it as well. Your thoughts about what LeBron needs to do tonight and what this game should mean to him?
Well, first of all, you know, LeBron, he's a special player. And I think that, you know, we put a lot of pressure on him, and he put a lot of pressure on himself.
Sure.
Okay, he got the one last year, and we should have applauded him, and we all did. We saluted him and said, okay, he finally arrived to the championship group. You know, we said, okay,
it's about damn time.
Yeah. Welcome to the club, LeBron. But at the same time, he can't wait like he did in game six. He can't wait. He cannot wait. Because it could be too late against the Spurs tonight if he waits to the fourth quarter to finally dominate. And you're right, Skip, and I got to give you credit, man.
Thank you.
Why?
You don't know what you're right about.
You know, you can't go in the post all day long, all game. I don't understand
I don't
that.
Allow me to disagree with both you and Skip, the great Magic Johnson. Let me say this to you.
No.
Let me explain. Let me explain real quick. I understand where you're coming from, but you and I were talking, you know, we talk a lot during the games now, and we saw, what did we see in San Antonio? One minute he got Kawhi on him. Another minute it's Danny Green. Another minute he collapses, and they're swarming him, and three dudes come out of nowhere. We talked about how flummoxed he was, how confused he was, and I think that that has something to do with why you can't be in the post, because Popovich isn't giving you the same look every time, Magic.
But see, when you, after the third game, you're not confused anymore. Stephen A.
Really?
No.
Against Pop?
I don't care who it is.
Okay.
I played against some of the best defenders, Dennis Johnson, and the team-wise, the Celtics.
Pippen.
They gave me, Pippen, they gave me different looks. By the third game, I understood what they were doing. And tonight, so what? Let them triple team him. Let them double team him. He sucks that double team, takes that triple team, pass out. Okay, tonight he's got to be in that post, or he's got to drive that ball to the basket. He was unstoppable in the fourth quarter.
Unstoppable.
But he has to do that from the first quarter on.
Well, why didn't he do it? Why hasn't he done it?
Thank you.
Why hasn't he done it?
I mean, if it's that simple, why hasn't he done it? I can't answer that for you. You know, sometimes we get so baffled with LeBron on the decisions that he makes, you know. But at the same time, he always corrects himself and always gets it right. Mm-hmm. He got it right in game six. You got to give him credit for that. But tonight is a one game. This is it. So I think that LeBron has to put his head down, take it to the basket.
That's what you expect from him tonight.
Yes. As well as still, he can still get his teammates involved. He can still be a passer, a facilitator. But look, superstars win game sevens. I've been
plain and simple.
Larry Bird won game seven against us in 84. He dominated 30-something points, like 15 rebounds. James Worthy, when we played Detroit, dominated game seven. So we had a big three. So one of us had to dominate for us to win. So who's going to dominate on either side?
Well, you know what
you're saying. The Spurs don't have to dominate. They just got to get 20, 15, another 15.
Right.
From Tony Parker, Tim Duncan, and Ginobili. Now, Dwayne Wade.
I was getting ready to ask it. That was my next question.
So if Dwayne Wade is not Dwayne Wade, the Heat going to be in a little trouble.
It's got to be LeBron then.
It's got to be LeBron. And LeBron has to see that. If he sees Dwayne can't be Dwayne because of his knee, he's
got
to
I got one more point.
Okay.
LeBron, it's not enough for him to see it. He's got to make the decision himself instead of letting Dwayne Wade or Spoelstra or anybody else make the decision for him to take over. LeBron in a game seven has to stand up and say, look, man, I'm watching you. We can barbecue and hug one another, sing Kumbaya later. Mm-hmm. But this game seven and take over. He's got to see it.
You're right. You're right. And you know what? Mm-hmm. Dwayne Wade also got to tell him.
That's right.
Yeah. I remember when Kareem used to come up to me, Irvin, I don't have it tonight.
Mm. Wow.
No problem. That's all I need
even
to
in
know.
A finals game?
If he was tired, his shot was off, whatever, he would say, hey, I need you to be the man tonight.
Wow.
No problem.
And by the way, what was Kareem's bounce back 2-day factor at age 37?
Great point, Skip. We got blew out the Memorial Day Massacre.
Yes. I mean, we 40. Got... It was bad. It was very bad, Matt. It was very bad.
This one, 40.
It was
40.
Very bad.
I remember 40.
You know, I hated coming to the show because I knew he was going to fight.
40. I remember. 40. Go ahead, Magic.
40.
So they blew us out. Scott Wettman came off the bench.
Scott
it was
Wettman.
9-for-9.
That's right.
You know? And so they crucified Kareem and us, right? The next day in the press, he's too old. He can't play any longer. And Pat Riley did something that was so important. That's why I went back to what you just said. Popovich did, Skip. For the first time in history, Pat Riley allowed somebody to ride on the team bus, and that was Kareem's parents.
Wow. Ooh.
The game
wow.
two.
Smart.
He had his best game of that series, game two, dominated. And so that allowed Kareem to feel comfortable and got his head right with his parents riding on the team bus all the way to the arena. And so that was a great coaching move by Pat Riley to allow that to happen. And so he that was his bounce back game.
You said a lot today, Magic. Who's winning game seven?
Wow. Wow. I picked Miami to win this series, right? And after what happened Tuesday, and after hearing Skip what happened with Popovich, they're going to have a rallying cry. It's going to be interesting because I think the Spurs is going to say, I hate what Magic said, and I want to show everybody that we can bounce back. We're mentally tougher than everybody's giving us credit for. And if Dwayne Wade is not Dwayne Wade, the Spurs will win this game. You know, if Dwayne is Dwayne, and all things even, I think Miami, because it's at home,
game seven,
will win.
Game seven on the road, San Antonio.